brothers, respected elders, all praises for Allah, the Lord of the universe. And we thank Him for having blessed us with Iman and Islam and made us in the Ummah of His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah guides those whom Allah wills. Hidayat, guidance, all qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah ta'ala. All good and bad is from Allah. Allah has created all of us. هو الذي خلقكم فمنكم كافر ومنكم مؤمن. Allah has created all people, and from them Allah made some believers and some as kafirs. ولو شاء ربك لآمن من في الأرض كلهم جميعا. If Allah so wanted, all the people of the world could have been believers. But that is not the way Allah decided things to be. Allah decided to create people and bless some with Iman and deprive others. In another verse, Allah says in the Quran, وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Allah has revealed the truth and made everything clear, and whosoever wants to believe, then let him believe, and whosoever wants to deny, then let them deny. Haqq is from Allah. Allah guides those whom Allah wills. But Allah has made a rule, a sunnah, qanoon. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Allah guides those whom He wills, but Allah will guide those who will strive and struggle. And strive and make effort, Allah will guide them. A person can't simply sit at home and relax and be complacent and not show any care and worry and concern and thinks everything will be okay. It will not be okay. Allah has made dunya darul asbab. If Allah wants, at the blink of an eye, if Allah so wishes, all the people of the world, the Jews, the Christians, the Hindus, the Sikhs, the Africans, the Asians, the Americans, the Arabs, the non-Arabs, all the people in the world in the spur of the moment can all become Muslims and believers. But Allah didn't make it that way. Allah sent His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as rahmatul lil alameen wa ma arsalnaka illa kafatan lin nasi bashiran wa nadhira. And commanded His beloved Prophet, Ya ayyuhar rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik, wa in lam taf'al fama ballaghta risalata. Convey my message, and if you don't, you would not have fulfilled the right of conveying and preaching and risala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam simply just did not sit and make dua in the vicinity of the Kaaba in front of Hajr al-Aswad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went from door to door. And he went, and whenever he had the opportunity, in whatever form, whenever, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tried to explain to people, to make them realize. He went to Taif, and he was stoned. And when he had the opportunity to pray against them, and the angel came, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, if you want, I can bring the mountains together on either side of the town and crush these people. If you want, I can do that. Or anything else which you suggest and recommend. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in spite of having this opportunity, then chose to forgive these people and pray for their hidayat. And he said, I am hopeful if these people don't believe, then in their offspring, generations to come, there will be people who will believe. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved Prophet of Allah, regarding whom Allah took a pledge even from all the prophets. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُم مِّن كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِّمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنصُرُنَّهُ. All the prophets had to offer their pledge and promise that when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam appears, even they will believe in him and assist him. So noble Imam al-Anbiya, Sayyid al-Anbiya, Sayyid al-Awwalin wal-Akhirin. In the night of Mi'raj, Allah gathered the prophets and Allah blessed and honored His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the opportunity to lead all the prophets in salah and be their imam. But even he had to go from people to people and preach the message of Allah. And he did not just become complacent and become content with only his du'as. Du'as are also essential. We have to ask Allah to guide us. And in the hadith which I recited, Allah says, يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديته. All of you people, you are all misled. You are all on the wrong path except those whom I guide. And when Allah guides people, مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُدِلَّ لَهُ. When Allah guides people, then no one can mislead them. وَمَنْ يُدْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. And when Allah misguides them, then nobody can guide them. Real guidance comes from Allah. Allah is the one who changes the hearts. يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ. In some of the du'as of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ يَا مُسَرِّفَ الْقُلُوبِ صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي على دينك. Oh, he who changes the hearts, who twists the hearts, manipulates the hearts, turn my heart to your ta'ah, to your obedience. And ya Allah, the Lord who flips the heart. Sometimes a person can be a Muslim and a believer and an obedient person to Allah and trying to pray and do these things. All of a sudden something can happen and that person can flip and change. That is why Allah has taught us a dua in the Quran as well. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. Ya Allah, having given us guidance, don't change our hearts away from guidance, away from Islam. There are many a people, Allahu Akbar, they come into Islam or they come into deen and by some means or another, then Allah deprives them. And these people, then they go away. And then Allah sometimes doesn't even give them tawfiq to come back. كَيْفَ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ قَوْمٍ كَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِيمَانِهِمْ وَشَاهِدُوا أَنَّ الرَّسُولَ حَقٌّ وَجَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. How will Allah possibly guide those people whom Allah blessed and Allah gave them guidance and made everything clear to them, and they chose to go against the commands of Allah and to turn away from the deen of Allah? Allah will never guide such people. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. What bigger zulm than this? Allah gave a person guidance, understanding of Islam, and enlightened their hearts with the nur of Iman, and then such people, then they chose otherwise. Then they chose otherwise. Allah has mentioned a story in the Quran about one such man, بَلَمْ بَعُورِ. وَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَى الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. Allah says, oh my beloved Prophet, tell them about the man. I had blessed and given him guidance. He was a pious man, a saintly man. And then, but subhanAllah, shaitan was on his case and then he gave in to shaitan. Shaitan is on everybody's case from the beginning till the end. He doesn't give up. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, when he was about to die, people, they were encouraging him to recite La ilaha illallah. And this is what people should do. When a person, when he's in his last moments and people think that he is about to die, then people should gather around such a person and not tell him directly to recite La ilaha illallah, but him, and in a medium voice, recite La ilaha illallah around him so that he can be encouraged to join in and recite La ilaha illallah. Because if you tell that person directly to recite La ilaha illallah, that person who's dying, he is under severe attack of shaitan at the moment. In the dying moments of a person, shaitan attacks him the most. And he knows that throughout his life he did what he did, but if he can persuade him to come away now, then his work is done. So he attacks him with full force in his dying moments. So under such pressure, don't put a person on the spot and telling him to recite La ilaha illallah, least he should deny and say, why should I? Or just leave me alone. And then in that person, this is very severe and dangerous for that person and could leave him to denying Iman and La ilaha illallah, in which case he could die as a kafir. But help him by reciting La ilaha illallah around him. So people gathered around Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmahullah and making talqeen of La ilaha illallah. And he said, not yet, not yet. And then he became unconscious. And when he regained his consciousness, he said to the people, you were encouraging me to recite La ilaha illallah. And there was shaitan standing by the door. I saw him and he said, oh Ahmad, you have escaped from my clutches. And I was telling him, not yet, not yet. I can't be too sure of myself. As long as I am alive, I can't be too sure of myself that I will die with Iman. And so Shaitan tries his best to lure a person away from La ilaha illallah, away from deen. And so the bigger a person, the bigger the Shaitan, and the more he attacks that person. So this Bal'am Ba'ur from Bani Israel, Shaitan came on his case. And then he followed him. And then he gave in to him. Allah says, وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَىٰ. Allah says, if I wanted to elevate him and save him, I could have. But this man, he fell for it. He gave preference to the glamour and the comfort of dunya. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا. Then Allah says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَثْ. He's like a dog. When you give him something, he barks. When you deprive him or when you hit him, he still barks. A dog, that's all he does, he barks. So a person who turns away from Allah, Allah made him Muslim, Allah gave him guidance, and Allah showed him the right path. But this person doesn't value it, and he gives preference to the glamour of dunya. In the eyes of Allah, such a person is like a dog. So we should repent to Allah and ask Allah to guide us. This is why Allah has made it obligatory upon every Muslim to seek hidayat from Allah. اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. In 32 rakats on daily basis, 17 faraid, 3 witr, and 12 sunnah, muwakkidah. We pray to Allah, اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ سِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. Ya Allah, show us the right path, the path of those upon whom you showered your mercy and blessings and favors, and not the path of those with whom you are angry and those who were led astray. And the ulama, they say, and those who were angry, with whom Allah was angry are the Jews, and those who were led astray are the Christians who made Isa alayhi salam as the son of Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Surely they committed kufr, those who said that Isa ibn Maryam is the son of Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَ. Verily, committed kufr, those who said Allah is a third of the three, those who believe in Trinity. And the Bani Israel, لَوْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَىٰ لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَإِسَى ابْنِ مَرْيَمْ. Even some of the prophets from Bani Israel, Dawood alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, they cursed the Jews. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. Because of their disobedience to Allah and the prophets, and their transgression going over the limits. كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَمْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ. And the other thing they did was when they would see people doing wrong in society, they would not stop them.